Welcome to Faith Life Ministries International, the home of miracles. Total gospel to total man.
Hallelujah. Glory be to Jesus. Brothers and sisters, welcome to the last day of our fasting for the month of November 2020, our month of divine exemption. Hallelujah. God has been good these past 2 days. This is the third day. We are grateful to God for His mercies that has kept us these 3 days in waiting upon Him. Lift your hands to God in thanksgiving. Hallelujah. We worship you, Most High God. We celebrate your goodness. We celebrate your faithfulness. Thank God for the gift of life. Thank God for mercy. Thank God for His goodness. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you in Jesus' name. Today, I'm not going to spend much time. I want to share with us today the hand of the Lord, because I would like us to end this fasting with God's mighty hand as an overseer over us, our family, and the works of our hands. And we journey through it into the month of December. And by December, again, we will be doing the last section of this prayer and fasting for the year 2020. Please prepare for it. Stay tuned so that you end the year well and end it in abundance and in plenty, not in sorrow and in pain, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Child of God, there is a huge difference between taking the stairs and the lift to the top of a story building. There is a huge difference. The both parties will not get there at the same time. The one taking the lift will obviously get to the top of the story building before the one taking the stairs will get there. That is what the hand of God does to the life of a man. It pushes you and grants you supernatural speed, which you use by faith and by grace to get to your destination on time. What others will be struggling to accomplish and to achieve, the hand of God is like that lift that takes you to the top of a story building, compared to those who are taking stairs, walking without grace. The hand of God pushes you and grant you supernatural speed to accomplish things naturally in your own energy of the flesh you will not be able to accomplish. Every time God wants to do the unusual in the life of a man, He releases His hand. That hand, we call it grace, but I like to call it, in the course of this teaching this evening, the hand of God. Every time God wants to do the unusual in a man's life, in his business, in his finances, in his career, He releases that hand. When the hand of God comes into a man's affair, it turns everything around for the good and for the better. May that be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Look at 1 Kings 18, verse 46. 1 Kings 18, verse 46. Some people are moving, but they are too slow. Some are not even moving at all. Look at this. 1 Kings 18, verse 46. And the hand of the Lord was on Elijah. Pakitia. He girded up his loins and ran before Ahab to the entrance of Jezreel. Look at the New Living Translation. Then the Lord gave special strength to Elijah. He tucked his clothes into his belt and ran ahead of Ahab's chariots all the way to the entrance of Jezreel. How did God give Elijah special strength? By His hand. By His hand. Brethren, in this life, some people are moving, some people are not moving at all, and some people are not just moving, they are flying by the hand of the mighty God, Jehovah Almighty, the creator of the heavens and the earth. It is that hand I bring to you this last day of this fasting, called grace, that from this day, whatever you have been struggling to accomplish, the hand of God pushes you to accomplish it in the name of Jesus Christ. You will begin to enjoy supernatural speed. that an old man will outrun the king on a chariot is nothing but God. A man of over 70 outrun the king on a chariot is nothing but the hand of God. Overtaking is allowed in the journey of life. Child of God, listen to me. Do not compare yourself with anyone. Don't sit down in despair and complain and murmur about those who you think have gone ahead of you, or people who are doing things that you think that you should be doing. No, do not compare yourself. Grace, the hand of God, can make you accomplish things beyond your own widest imagination. Those who you think have gone ahead of you, by the end of these prayers, the hand of God will grant you what I call supernatural overtaking. You will overtake, you will pursue, you will recover in the name of Jesus. Just the way Elijah outrun the king on a chariot, that is how they will see you coming. You will just be overtaking them, not in pride, not in the flesh, not making boast in your energy of the flesh, but in the grace of God and in doing the will of God. I release that hand upon you from today. I release it upon your matter. I release it upon your business. I release it upon your children. I release it upon your household in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Ezekiel 37, verse 1 and 2. Ezekiel 37, verse 1 and 2. The unusual is a product of the hand of God. Ezekiel 37, verses 1 and 2. The hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the spirit and set me down in the midst of the valley which was full of dry bone. The hand of God carries people. God will pick you by his hand. Listen to me, child of God. God himself is going to recommend you to they that are in power. I'm speaking to someone now prophetically. God himself is going to recommend you to they that are in power. God will raise people that will announce what you carry. God will raise helpers that will take you from the wilderness to the palace. God will raise for you voices. People will be talking for you even in your absence. People will be recommending you even in your own absence without your knowing from today. Say amen. So shall it be in the name of Jesus Christ. Look at verse 2. Glory be to Jesus. And caused me to pass by them round about. And behold, there were many in the open valley. Lo, they were very dry. But the hand of the Lord carried him. The hand of the Lord carried him. See what God told me. Sometimes the Spirit will lead you into the valley. You will find yourself in situations and ask yourself, why am I here? But the hand of God will cause you just to see things. The hand of God carried him into the valley of dry bones and showed him dry bones. Sometimes the hand of God will lead you into situations that you will find yourself and you will ask yourself, Lord, what am I doing here? Why am I in the valley of dry bones? It's just for a season. God is only trying to show you something. The hand of the Lord took him into the valley of dry bones. The hand of the Lord did not take him here to the mountaintop. Sometimes before God takes you to the mountain, he will take you through the valley. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. You are not building a house in the valley. You are walking through. Listen to me, child of God. I told you, don't be afraid of the storm. As I close this fasting, I know the hand of God is upon you, because somebody is saying to me, but man of God, if the hand of God is upon me, why is my situation a valley like? That is what I'm showing you. Sometimes the hand of the Lord will pick you and carry you through the valley. It is only for a season, to show you and to teach you. So the hand of God carries people. Every time God is said to do the unusual, the extraordinary in the life of a person, he releases his hand. And like I said, for the course of the teaching, the hand of the Lord here is the grace of God. Every time God wants to do the unusual in a man's finances, in a man's career, in a man's business, he releases his hand upon that person. So God's hand is capable of carrying us. I decree and I declare in the name of Jesus, as we end this fasting from now henceforth, may you enjoy transportation by the hand of God. May the hand of God, through grace, supernaturally increase your speed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You will run, you will overtake, you will recover. In the name of Jesus, by the assistance of the hand of God, in Jesus' mighty name. He said, the hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the spirit and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of dry bones. Verse 2. Glory to God, and caused me to pass by them round about, and behold, there were very many in an open valley, and lo, they were very dry. How can the hand of God carry you into the valley, not to the top of the mountain? Remember my message from the first day. Friends, as you journey to the other side, you will come across the storms of life. When the hand of God carries you, he will carry you through the valley, not to stay in the valley, but through the valley, from the valley then to the mountain top. There will always be an opposition before you get to your destination, but don't be afraid, child of God. It's only but a process. He carried him through to see and to watch. Go read the whole of Ezekiel 37. He saw it. He asked the Lord what it was. The Lord told him what to do. Prophesy to the valley of dry bones. He prophesied. Life returned to the valley of dry bones. And out of the valley of dry bones, a strong army rose up and came out of it. And that will be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Listen to this very clearly. Sometimes the Spirit of God will lead you into the valley. You will find yourself in situations and you will ask yourself, Lord, why am I here? It's happened to me several times. If it hasn't happened to you before, it will happen to you. You will find yourself in situations and you will ask yourself, Lord God, why am I here? Because it is the hand of God that will lead you there. It is the hand of God that will carry you there. Hallelujah. But it's carrying you there because you have to go through that test to come out with your testimony. You have to go through that trial so that you can come out triumphant. You have to go through that storm so that you can cross over to the other side. Don't despair. Stand firm. The storm is over. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. It is that hand I release upon you today, that as you journey through the remaining days of November and journey through December, and by the mercy of God, if Jesus tarries, into 2021, you will find yourself accomplishing things without your own energy required because of the hand of God, in Jesus' mighty name. Look at Isaiah 59 verse 1. Glory be to Jesus. Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened. Hallelujah. Friends, the grace of God is not shortened, that it cannot save. There is no situation that you are in that the hand of God cannot pick you out from. There is no crisis that you are faced with that the hand of God cannot rescue you from. I decree and I declare to you listening to me right now, be it maritally, financially, spiritually, whatever it is that you are going through, no matter what it is, the hand of God is capable to reach out for you there and take you out of it, child of God. And that will happen to you today in the name of Jesus. Neither is his ear heavy that he cannot hear. Glory be to Jesus. God does not only hear prayers, he answers prayers. Just as your prayers will be answered today with signs and wonders in Jesus' mighty name. One more scripture, John chapter 10, verse 29. Hallelujah. Oh, makoshikatele babakoba. Matele pronokoshikatele babahandi gadaba. Listen to this. My Father, which gave them me, is greater than all. No man kazikro toni mana angriaba. No man is able to pluck them out of my Father's hand. Child of God, the hand of God is capable to keep you, to protect you, and to preserve you. No devil, no sorcerer, no charm can plug you out of the hand of the Father. I don't care what your enemies are saying or doing. I don't care what arrows they are firing or shooting. Do you know where you are? You are in the most secure place ever anyone can ever imagine to be. You are in the palm of the hand of God. See the New Living Translation. Nobody, not in the spirit, not in the physical, can take you out of God's hand. For my Father has given them to me, and he is more powerful than anyone else. Show me that devil. Show me that evil one that is stronger than the God whom you serve. No one can snatch them from the Father's hand. Kituli mine hungria, except he says so. I bring you the hand of God, which is the grace of God. You are secured and you are safe in the hand of God. Thank God for the storms. Thank God for the challenges. But God is taking you to the other side. If you have not given your life to Jesus, you need to do so. Because they whom the Father has given to me, you have to surrender your life to Christ to be part of this family. No devil is permitted to snatch them out of the hand of the Father. Lift your hand and say, Jesus, come into my life as my Lord and my Savior. I surrender my heart to you. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Hallelujah. If you've prayed that prayer, you are saved and you are secured. And now, congratulations, you are in the palm of his hand. Hallelujah. Glory be to Jesus. Begin to speak in the unknown language if you can. If you cannot, just begin to praise God. Begin to thank God for the hand of God. Begin to thank God for the grace of God. Begin to thank God. Thank God for his hand, which through grace from today is going to turn your life around for the better. Things will begin to work for you. That hand will begin to push you, grant you increase, speed. Thank you, Father. Lift your hands and say, my Father, my helper, fast forward my destiny by your grace through your hand in the name of Jesus. My Father, my helper, fast forward my destiny by your grace through your hand in the name of Jesus. Just as the hand of God grant Elijah supernatural speed, let the hand of God through grace begin to fast forward your destiny. Wherever they have been delayed in any area of your life, stagnation in any area of your life, by the hand of God through grace, I decree and I declare now, fast forward in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Say number two, say, my Father, let me experience your hand in my matter. Let me experience your hand in my case, financially, spiritually, and otherwise. Begin to pray. Lord, put your hand in my matter. I present my case to you, O God. I bring my matter before your throne of mercy. Let your hand step into it, Lord. In my home, in my children's life, in my health, my body, my finances, my career. Put your hand, O God, upon me, O God. Let me see your hand at work. Rekatatene moko shikataya. Mikutuna misekli tenimo wokotaya. Rekatatene boko shikataya. Neko tondole boko sigradiyava. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God. Father, I thank you. There is a woman that is in between two opinion. You asking God, should I go, should I not go? The Lord say, you don't need to go, because what you are doing at home is wonderful. God is the one that positioned you in that business. He gave you that company to supervise, and you are very committed in your local assembly at home, the Lord said, do not take that offer abroad. Hallelujah. Not all that glitter that is gold. It might be good, but it might not be God. Makase ketele makusha kinda hadombeli gredine kedibruandia. You are believing God for scholarship abroad. I decree in the name of Jesus, receive supernatural favor in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. If you have any sickness in your body, lay your hands where the sickness is. I decree and I declare, be healed and be made whole in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray for everyone under the influence of my voice. Let your hand come upon them by grace. Come upon the works of their hands. Come upon their lives, their marriage, their home, their health. In the name of Jesus. As we conclude the fasting for the month of November, I decree that you grant them supernatural speed. I decree that you grant them supernatural help. I decree that you grant them supernatural favor in the name of Jesus, the Son of the Living God. Thank you, mighty Father. Thank you, Jehovah. Thank you, the Prince of Peace. Child of God, congratulations. I'm looking forward for your testimonies. Get in touch with us on the numbers on the screen. And don't forget to follow us every Sunday, 9 a.m. on Facebook and on YouTube. Your life will never be the same again. God's hand takes you through the storm and take you to the other side. You are blessed and lifted in Jesus' name. Amen.